Hello friends, in this video, I'm going to explain you how to implement increment and decrement operator in one program using C. Okay, so let's see how it is working. So here I'm writing a program. Has include stdio.h, again void main opening curly bracket, then I'm writing int a is equal to 1 semicolon, int b is equal to 1 semicolon, next int c is equal to a plus plus or b minus semicolon. This is a plus plus, that is post increment of a, then post decrement of b. Within that or operator is used. So let's see how it is working. So after that I'm writing printf function to display the value of c and the value of b. So I want to display the value of c as c equal to percentile d. C semicolon. In the next statement, I'm writing slash n b equal to percentile d double quotation and b semicolon. We have to see what is the value of c and what is the value of b. Okay, so here you can see I'm declaring two variables. One is a, another is b. A is 1, b is 1. So here in this statement, look at this. First, we know that in post increment operator, first the value is assigned to the first, if the value is assigned, then the value is incremented. So here in this case, we are using OR operation. So we know that anything, if one value is 1, that means the total result will be 1. That means true. Suppose you can see in OR operator, true, false, 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 true, true. Okay. These are the different combinations. So here I'm writing, suppose this is X, suppose this is Y. And the OR operator will work it like this. False, true, that will be true. False and false, that will be false. True and true, that true or true, that will be true. True or false, that will be true. That means if the first one is true, then no need to calculate the second one. So here, if the first value, that means a plus plus, that is the value of a, is true, then no need to calculate the second operator. So here, the same thing is shown. That means int c equal to a plus plus, the value of c will be assigned to 1. The value of a will be assigned to c, that will be 1. So c value will be 1. Again, b is 1, so b minus minus. So here you see that this value is not required to calculate. So because a is 1, that means true. So the total statement is true. So c will be assigned 1, but b need not have to be calculated because already we have got the result of this line or this statement. So that b will be the same, that is b will be 1. So output will be c equal to 1 and b equal to 1. So let's see how we can run it in Dev C++ editor. Here I'm opening my Dev C++ editor. So now you can see Control N, open the source file. I'm writing the program as include stdio.h. Again, void main. Next, I'm writing int h equal to 1 semicolon int b is equal to 1 semicolon. Again, int c is equal to a plus plus or b minus minus semicolon. Next, in the next statement, using printf function to display the value of c, c is equal to percentile d, then comma c semicolon. Next, next statement. Okay, within double quotation, I'm writing value of p. So before that, I'm using slash n. Value of p is equal to percentile d, then comma p. Okay, semicolon. So my program is complete. Let's see how what value is represented by c and b. Okay, so here I am compiling the program. So while I will compile the program, it will ask me to save the program. So I am saving the name of, for example, operator suppose 2. You can give any name here. So next, save as type, and I am selecting it as c source files or .c extension. Okay, save. While I will save, it will compile the program, and you can see the compilation result. Its errors are 0 and warnings are 0. That means my compilation, my program is correct. Let's see how the value is displaying. Okay, I am now running the program or executing the program. Yes, you can see the value of c is 1 and the value of b is 1. Okay, so that b, the value of b need not have to be calculated, because the total expression, the result of total expression is found from the first variable, that is from a. As a is 1, this value is true, the total expression is true. That's why compiler will need not calculate, the second variable, that is b minus minus, will not calculate. Okay, so this is the concept I want to I explained it. Okay, so if you like this video, then subscribe my channel and share it with your friends. Thanks for watching.